This is Cherry Vanilla at the RCA Studios in New York, and today I have the honor to interview David Bowie. Hi, David.
Say hello, David. Hello, David.
Last night I spoke to you about the letter Z coming up very often with you, Ziggy Stardust and your baby's name Zoe, mm-hmm. and your road manager named Z. Yeah. And I asked you what the significance of it was. I wonder if you could just...
I'm not altogether sure. It keeps cropping up in everything I do. It haunts me. It's a very haunting letter for me.
Also, Aladdin Sane. Do you, in choosing names like this, I mean, Aladdin Sane and the Genie, does this come from some magical past life of yours or something?
No, not at all. I just grab at whatever name suits the material that I'm writing. I don't know where anything comes from.
Aside from entertaining, do you have a message?
Anything that I can take in that I pass out is the information available.
Do you take in information from someplace other than the confines of this planet, for instance?
I'm knowledgeable of that. I leave that for other people with more insight to assess whether I do or not. I just pass out information that I gather.
Do you feel a relationship, any special relationship with Mars, or is that...
I feel as close to any hitherto named planet that, as I feel to Earth.
When writing your songs, do they usually come, do your lyrics come in a stream of consciousness kind of thinking? I mean, do you think of a central theme and work around it, or do the words just...
The whole thing comes at once, generally, and very quickly.
And very quickly.
Yeah.
Do the lyrics usually come before that? The music?
The melody generally comes pre, and the lyrics come as poems, and I join lyrics with different melodies. I tend to stockpile both.
Oh, I see.
And fit together where
and sometimes you find that lyrics...
It never comes really as a whole thing.
It doesn't?
Not often.
In your plans for this tour,
yeah.
Can you tell us in what way it's changing, the stage act is changing?
Well, it'll be a longer show.
Oh, what? A longer show?
Yeah.
Than last time?
But, I guess at least an hour and a half.
Good.
Possibly 2 hours in some places.
Good.
We can do it.
You're adding some musicians to the band.
Mm-hmm.
You're expanding the band.
I'm not expanding the band so much as adding people to the show. The band have been and probably always will be the Spiders, Mick Ronson, Woody Woodmansey and Trevor Boulder. But we have now some backup musicians and singers that have joined us for the tour, being Mike Garson on piano, who's from New York, Bucks and Ken Fordham, who are sax players who come from England, and two singers, one Jess McCormack and the other one Hutch, who sing, play guitar and congas and percussive instruments.
And Hutch and Jess are childhood friends, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
And you and Hutch were in a band once called Feathers?
Mm-hmm.
What did Feathers do? It did some kind of multimedia
show? That was what it was called at the time. Multimedia show.
You showed films and slides and things?
Well,
danced?
Yeah, it was more like an oral mime company. It spoke as well as mimed. We had one ballet dancer, and Hutch wrote poetry a lot in those days, played guitar, and I did mime. It was interesting.
Word has it that you're being considered for the part of Valentine Michael Smith.
Good heavens.
Is there any truth to that?
You better ask my manager.
All right. Do you like the story? Would you like to play it?
Yes. I think so.
And also do the soundtrack for the film?
I've had a daughter do that.
You haven't done any film music yet?
Never.
Sounds like a logical next step.
I have one theme already written that I was keeping for a film.
Have it in reserve?
Yes.
You have lyrics in reserve too?
No. Just music.
Do things just come to you in poetic rhyme, and you you sing them, you say them, and perhaps later on they gain some meaning, or are they things that you firmly believe when you say them?
I see. When I originally write them down, I believe them in one sense, but they often change their sense and tense and logic after I've put the tracks down. That frequently happens.
Yeah.
The whole emphasis shift is different after we've recorded the material.
Well, you're not into the tarot at all, but you did study Tibetan Buddhism.
Yeah.
How long did you do that?
Long time.
Did you go away to a monastery?
Very nearly. I had a friend who was the Dalai Lama's aide. He was a Tibetan Lama. And he lived in London, and we saw a lot of each other.
That's the extent of your study. You didn't go off into the mountains and meditate for a few years or anything.
Oh, I certainly was meditating for a long time.
Did you ever go through a drug period?
It did occur one period, yeah.
LSD?
Yeah.
Did you write songs under LSD?
No, I've never worked so badly in my life.
Really? You never performed under it?
No.
And I know you're very opposed to drugs. What is your feeling about them now and the whole?
I don't have any particular feeling about them.
You just don't like them?
No.
And they don't add to your creativity at all?
No.
Do you feel removed from the body and the feel that you create on the planet?
Until I'm performing or writing, I mainly feel pretty much of an empty vessel.
When you're performing and writing, you're fulfilled.
I don't particularly feel, period.
What about when you're making love? Do you feel real then?
I'm not quite sure of the definition of
Do you feel
for
as
real.
Fulfilled as when you're performing?
Oh, yes.
Is it pretty much reaching the same place, the same level?
No. Lovemaking is a different level.
Okay, you're bringing Zoe here.
Yeah.
Do you have any bad thoughts about bringing Zoe to America?
I did last year because he was so little, but he's very big now. I think he can probably cope as well as I can.
Do you feel you have to cope with...
He's nearly 19 months now.
Is America difficult for you to cope with?
I'm difficult to cope with in America. I find I'm different when I'm in America.
Do you find it pleasant here?
I find it very, very exciting.
You find the energy level much higher than London, for instance?
Yes. Yes, there's a power energy over the cities here, which attracts a lot of attention.
Ever see any flying saucers?
Possibly.
You're not quite sure if you saw them or not?
Well, I'm quite sure that I possibly saw them.
Where was that?
Hampstead, which is just outside of London.
What was your feeling when you saw them?
They keep very tight time schedules. I had times.
Did you feel a rush of fright or...?
No. I just wish they'd changed colour because they were orange and they should have been redder. But,
did you hope they would land?
Colour was wrong. No, not particularly. Left it up to them to decide. I don't want to hustle anybody.
Is there any great thing you want to do other than perform? Any great yearning you have for archaeology or something strange, digging in the pyramids or...
Not at all.
Just perform and entertain. Yeah. Make love. Have Zoe's. What are some of the other songs on the album?
The new album?
Yeah.
Panic in Detroit.
Obviously written in Detroit.
Yes.
Was there a panic in Detroit when you were there?
No, very few of my things have taken place. Well, some of them have now, but not when I write them, they don't take place. Usually comes later.
And time?
Time.
You mentioned Billy of the Dolls in Time.
Mm-hmm.
He was a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And what about the, there's one called Lady Shining Soul?
Grinning Soul.
Grinning Soul. Where was that?
Really, where was that? It was someone I met, who I found enchanting.
In America also?
No, in England.
So that's one that didn't come from your American tour.
That was a London song.
Aladdin Sane is sort of a rock jazz number. Are you kind of heading towards jazz
now? No. The idea of playing around a melody rather than playing the actual thing is something that interests me. But I'm not necessarily going to confine that to calling it a jazz form. An interpretation of a melody is nearer to it.
Do you think you'll ever do just an acoustic show?
Yes.
That would be exciting.
Yes, I want to do that very much.
Just you and guitar?
Yes. And whatever else comes to hand.
What other instruments do you play?
I play alto sax and a little piano.
Some people feel you're by saying you're bisexual and by kind of flaunting that in a way, that you're trying to...
Who's flaunting that?
Well, I mean, you say it in interviews.
The only people that ever bring it up are people who are interviewing me.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, you're very masculine to me. But,
Well, I am a stud.